It's a great pleasure now to be joined by good friend and colleague Richard Atwood. Richard, we're here beside the famous car, the winning car from 1970. How does it feel to be back again at Goodwood?
Well, always a pleasure at Goodwood. I've done every revival except the first one when I didn't know anything about it at all. But I used to famously bring my 917, my own 917 here just for the festival. I wouldn't race it, but Lord March invited me every year. So I started something. This looks the same car, but because I decked mine out the same colour. But this is actually the factory car. Yeah.
So obviously, the most famous Porsche that there is, Richard. Tell us a little bit about the car. What's it like to drive?
Well, initially it was really bad, and then it became a lot better when they sorted out the aerodynamics. But once it sorted, it was one of the worst cars I drove, but then probably one of the best cars I drove. So evolution really happened in 69, and then they got it right in 70, 71, because they won the world championship for 3 years. So they did it right in the end.
Richard, what's your proudest Porsche moment?
Gosh. Well, I think for Porsche, you know, Le Mans is a manufacturer's thing, and it's the drivers. Yeah, you've got to have two good drivers who work together well, but really it's the car that gets you there. And so really, I mean, I think from a perspective of Porsche, then I think the 1970 race win was brilliant for Porsche. But personally, I probably drove, you know, Grand Prix races were probably more self-satisfying for me as a one-driver thing.
Okay. Richard, we're very privileged up at the Porsche Experience Centre at Stilwerson.
Sure.
you still work with us up there as a Porsche driving consultant. Yeah. Do you still enjoy coaching drivers, Richard?
If I did, I wouldn't do it. But I like to bring on Porsche owners with their cars. I think it's a very satisfying job to do. And you start the day or the morning or whatever it is with whoever you've got, and you can see an improvement, and it's very rewarding, actually. It's something that I like to do, actually, for that reason, really. Job satisfaction, I think, is really a major part of what it's for.
And Richard, potentially tomorrow driving up the hill in the 917, you're looking forward to that?
Yeah, I've done it lots of times, so it'll be another memory lane job, really. But I know the car very well, I know the hill very well, so it'll be quite relatively easy. I mean, I might make a mistake, but I don't think so. You know, it's like putting on an old pair of shoes or gloves, isn't it, really? It's you know, it's like it was only a few years ago when it, in fact, it was, you know, 40 years ago.
And Richard, clearly a priceless vehicle. How hard are you pushing when you're driving up the hill in the car then?
Well, the great thing is that a car can always be refettled. The driver can't necessarily be totally refettled. So that is always in the back of our minds, that we can actually go a little bit further than you might think you can. But Klaus is very protective of his car, so I'll probably be quite reserved in a way. But no, we'll be going fast, you'll see a slide or two.
We'll look forward to that. Richard, it's a pleasure as always. Thanks very much for all your help. Thank you.
Okay, Goddy. Yes, we'll see you back at work, back at school.